Hi, I'm Stephen Feuerstein, and I write practically perfect PLSQL. So I talked in general about what constitutes hard coding, this idea that something's not going to change so I can repeat it in multiple places and pretty much hope and pray that it doesn't change. Let's take a look at a specific example. So let's take a look at line 5 of this code and link to it line 10 and link to that line 17. Just on those three different lines that I mentioned, there are three different hard codings, but I'm not going to worry about all that right now. What I want to focus on is the declaration in line 5. LName is declared to be VARCHAR2100. So here's my initial tip. I suggest that you consider any VARCHAR2 declaration with an hard-coded value, and you always have to have a hard-coded value, to be a bug in your code, unless it's the single point of definition for that data type, and I'll come back and explain what that means in just a moment. But in general, if you see a VARCHAR2 declaration in your programs, in the declaration sections of your code, bug. How can that be? You might be saying, or another way of saying it is, oh my gosh, you're saying I have 10,000 more bugs than I thought I had in my code? Bad news. So why? All right, well, let's take a look at how it's being used. I'm fetching the full name of an employee, last, comma, first, into that local variable LName. The local variable is being populated on line 17. So I needed to declare a variable to hold that expression, last name, comma, first name. Now, what I'd like to be able to do, and I'm sure you're aware of this feature, is percent type it. In other words, say that LName should be table.column percent type. And then every time my table structure changes, my code will be automatically recompiled and will take up the new definition of that column. Beautiful feature. The problem is, I have a derived column, last comma first, and I can't do like percent type of this plus percent type of that. It just doesn't work. So what do I do? Well, I need to make sure that the variable is big enough to hold my last name and first name. So what I'm gonna do is take a look at the employees table. If I look at a description of employees, it shows me that the last name is up to 25 characters in length. The first name is up to 20 characters in length. Let's add one for the comma, 20, 25, comma, 46. Great, I'm gonna double that. I'm gonna make it 100, 100. That way it'll never get to be too big. It'll never exceed that size. We'll never get a value error exception when the fetch is performed, right? No, I'm sure you're saying, no, Stephen, that's not true at all. Why is that not true? Because it's not guaranteed that that employees table is always gonna look like that. What if the DBA comes along and says, well, we got some new employees, they got really long last names, we better extend the size of these columns. Last name is now 500, first name is now 200. We change the table, or the DBA changes the table. My code doesn't automatically recompile, or it doesn't automatically take up the new declaration of the new sizes of those columns because it's hard-coded. And then the first time that a person's name is fetched and it's a really big name, my code blows up. Wow. So how do I get around that? Well, there are actually a couple of possibilities. One is I could add a virtual column onto my table that has this expression in it and it would automatically be sized appropriately. I could create a view that has this expression in it and it would automatically, the name of that column inside the view would have that size dynamically created. And there may be good reasons for doing that, but in general, you don't want to create a new database object or a new column in a table just to handle the problem of declaring something in my code that can't be expressed with percent type. A more general and really excellent solution is to take advantage of subtypes. Subtypes, what are subtypes? Well, a subtype is a new application-specific type that you can define in your code that is based on something else. So in general, what you want to do is use subtypes to declare application-specific types that can't be expressed through percent type or percent row type. Let's take a look. So I have a package called employees RP. That means employees rules package. So all the rules associated with the employee table, that the minimum salary for a CEO has to be 10 million, what is and how do you construct the full name of an employee, it's all contained here. So I have a function called full name that takes the last name and the first name and returns, well, what is that? It returns full name. You'd think it would return VARCHAR2, right? What is full name? Full name is a subtype. So full name on line 10, I declare it to be a subtype, and it is nothing more than and nothing less than a VARCHAR2 10,000. Or maybe it's a VARCHAR2 1,000. Or maybe it doesn't matter what it is. The point is that it's hidden behind the name full name T. And then I can go back to my code and I can say, I don't want to hard code this declaration, I want to soft code it. And I want to soft code it to be employee rule RP, full name, T. So now my declaration of LName is a redirect to that package definition. It's really the same as a percent type in the sense that I haven't said what it is, I've said what it's based on. And now every time I need to change this, for example, the DBA says, oh, we've got really long names coming in now. We've got a first name that could be 500. We've got a last name that could be 20,000. What are you gonna do about that, developer? No big deal. I'm gonna go to my package spec. I'm gonna change this to, let's say, 32767. Biggest name possible today in Oracle 11 or 12 or whatever version you're on. I recompile the package. My procedure recompiles as a result, and my new definition is in place. So what I've done is take a constrained declaration, a VARCHAR2 declaration, and every VARCHAR2 declaration is a constraint. You have to provide a maximum size. And I've taken that out of this specific instance of code, and I've replaced it with a name. And in general, that's the way you get rid of hard coding. You replace the details of the implementation with a name, and the name hides the details and tells you what it is. So my code ends up being more self-documenting. I don't need to comment what that thing is. It's a full name, it's pretty obvious. In terms of the expression that creates the full name, that's another hard coding, and it should just be put inside the function, and then you call the function, and I'll talk about that in a different presentation. But again, I would go back to the very simple rule that you can follow. Every VARCHAR2 declaration should be considered a bug in your code, unless it's this kind of declaration, unless it's the single point of definition through the subtype. If you follow this rule, you'll have way fewer chances of breakage over time. And this is one of those classic examples where you write the code today, it works fine, goes into production, works fine. Years go by. You're gone. Maybe your son or daughter is now maintaining your code. Is this what you want to leave with your son or daughter? No. You want to make it so that as these data structures change, as your data volume grows, as things modify, your code automatically adapts as much as possible. Or if you can't automatically adapt, because there's nothing automatic about this, you change it in one place, the single point of definition. So thanks for joining me on this talk. Thanks for getting rid of all your VARCHAR2 declarations and putting them into subtypes. Happy coding.